Hello friends, today we are going to learn about codes of ethics in pharmacy. So there are total 7 codes of ethics that we are going to learn in this video, which are beneficence, non-maleficence, autonomy, paternalism, veracity, justice, fidelity. In exam, they will give you a scenario, and a question will be like, at the end of the scenario they will ask which ethical code did the pharmacist or the physician violate or break, which ethical code did pharmacist or physician uphold or follow, or simply they can ask a simple definition of that ethics. Okay, so there are 3 types of questions that could come in exam. Now our first code of ethic is beneficence. Beneficence itself, the word shows that it's all about providing benefit to the patient. Do best for patient. For example, if a patient is going for a vacation and he asked you to refill his medication more than for 3 months, and you know that the history of patient is clear and there is no abuse history or dependency history, then you can refill it. So it will benefit the patient, he get more medicines and he can spend vacation easily. Similarly, like replace drugs covered by plans. Plans means insurance plans. Sometimes pharmacists replace brand drug to the generic because generic are covered by insurance and they are generally cheaper. Then educate patient about therapy, about current therapy, about side effects, about what they should expect, and what to notice. These are the things that enhance the patient adherence to the therapy. This will give benefit to the patient. Insurance claims, and refer patient to the physician or emergency. These are some examples of beneficence. Always remember that if they ask about insurance claim in the exam question or refill, these are the keywords which you have to look for. If they are asking about these things, this is the answer will be beneficence. The second one is non-maleficence. Non-maleficence is preventing harm. For example, prevent from side effects, drug interaction, toxicity, and solve drug related problems. So if you notice that it is all about side effects, interaction, and toxicity. So if you feel that in exam the question there is a sense of side effect, if the patient counsel up if a physician pharmacist counsel a patient and it prevent from side effect, then it is non-maleficence. And if they ask that patient didn't counsel the pharmacist didn't counsel the patient, and because of non-counseling side effect could happen, then you will choose non-maleficence. So there is a slight difference between beneficence and non-maleficence. So if you sense that the question is asked about side effect, go for non-maleficence. If they are the questions stated nothing about side effect, drug interaction, toxicity, then choose beneficence. Our third one is autonomy. Autonomy allow patient to make his final decision about recommended therapy. So patient can refuse the therapy, patient can refuse surgeries. You cannot force a patient, but if a patient denies and said that I don't want to refill or I don't want this medication, you can counsel him or her, but you cannot impose your beliefs and your decisions on patient. There is a right of patient to make his final decision. He is responsible for his health, for his disease, for his current condition. Patient can take ODC medications. Next is paternalism. Paternalism is when health professional reject patient's decision, give priority to own beliefs and opinion. So I always remember it like a parents. So parents sometimes impose their decision on kids. So remember that paternalism is imposing own belief or own decision on patient. Even if a pharmacist is picking a cough syrup for a patient by himself, this is a very low type paternalism because the patient didn't pick the medicine by himself. A pharmacist can give option and the final decision which one medicine patient want to take is final decision is always patient's decision. Next is veracity. So veracity is patient has right to know truth about his her medical condition, about his her drug therapy. Explain everything to the patient with honesty and without hide anything is veracity. Question could come that a physician call you that don't tell the side effect of the patient, otherwise patient will not take the medication. So this is non-veracity. This is against the code of ethic, okay? And similarly, if a cancer patient who is terminally ill and could die soon, so you have to tell everything. Although sometimes it's very hard to tell the patient the truth, but it's his right to know true medical condition, true things about the therapy. So this come under veracity. Then justice. Justice means equality, being fair, provide service on first come first served basis. So question could come in exam that there is a patient who is regular customer. Only one patient came, and in scenario two, there is a whole family came to your pharmacy take medication. So definitely a patient with whole family give you more benefit. So you counsel and entertain that family more than a single patient. So this is injustice. You have to counsel everyone on equality basis. Similarly, a question can come that a patient who don't listen to you and you counsel every time, but still you have to counsel. Don't think that now I'm not going to counsel this patient because he doesn't listen to me. So don't differentiate between new and old patient, regular, irregular patient. These are some examples of justice. Always remember that whatever, like if a question can come that there is a long line and a patient came and start shouting and said that he needs a medication before everyone, so what will you do? You will do justice. You will serve everybody first come first serve basis. Just remember that. Then last one is fidelity. Be loyal with patient. Work for patient connect interest rather than own. Prescribe extra medication that patient does not need is infidelity. For example, if you prescribe a vitamin to the patient which they doesn't need, but because vitamins are general medication, so you prescribe so that your sale will increase. Dispense medication that can harm patient. Or reason behind these act is fear of losing customer or increase pharmacy sale. So as I said that if you give a patient multivitamin which the patient doesn't need, but intention is to increase the sale of your pharmacy, of course, so this is infidelity. Similarly, if a physician write a prescription that has to be corrected, or you have to talk to the physician but you didn't because you have fear that if you do that, the patient will go to the other pharmacy and you will lose the customer. So this is infidelity. You don't need to think like this. Regular customers are regular customers. You have to act according to the code of ethics. Now, when I was searching with these things, I found a very some important links which I'm showing here. This is OCP info. Basically, it is Ontario College of Pharmacists website where I found description about code of ethics the best. If you got time, please go through with this website. It has all description with examples, as well as there is a code of ethics, a visual overview. So there is a whole video on how you will choose the answer and how you will act when you come across with a situation. How will you justify or judge your act? There is a visual overview here, a summary. To remember, this is beneficence, non-maleficence, justice and fidelity. So I like it and I recommend it. If you have time, please go through with it. Thanks for watching. That's all for today. Please share and subscribe. Bye for now.